Central Coast Leagues is proud to announce a significant internal redevelopment of the club, which will commence in the next couple of months and will take close to 12 months to complete. Included in the development is new reception areas, our fresco gaming and updated dining facilities throughout the ground floor of the club. These changes will be a great refresh of the facilities and enable members to sit in comfort and enjoy a drink or dine with friends. Plans of the new facilities will be on display in the club in the near future.
Welcome to Plume Park in Lisaro for the John Hutchinson testimonial match, where the Central Coast Mariners are going to take on a hand-picked John Hutchinson 11. John Hutchinson's testimonial match to be played very shortly. Here are some interviews with players who will be playing and coaching during this match. We caught up with them a little bit earlier.
Joined by Central Coast Mariners former goalkeeper. He was there season one. John Hutchinson was there season one. He's here to celebrate here tonight after 10 years of football with John Hutchinson here at the Central Coast Mariners. Danny Vukovic. Danny, welcome to Plume Park.
That's good to be here, mate.
And John Hutchinson, he was here at the start as you were. Tell us about season one and how John Hutchinson helped shape your career.
Look, it was an amazing time in my life to be a professional footballer at that age. And you know, Hutch was pretty young then as well, a few years older than me, but he had a lot of experience in the old NSL. So it was nice to have someone close to my age to bounce things off when need be.
Couple of grand final experiences for yourself with the Central Coast Mariners. John Hutchinson missed out in season one against Sydney FC, but in season three against the Newcastle Jets, it was one of the most feisty F3 derbies, and it was John Hutchinson and yourself at the thick of it again.
Yeah, it's probably one to forget for me. It's always nice to play in grand finals, and losing was heartbreaking, and obviously what I did at the end of the game was something that changed my career, and it was very tough to take, but you learn from your mistakes, and I think it's made me a better person in the end.
And then when you look back at the Central Coast Mariners now after 10 years and John Hutchinson then taking over as the captain, what, looking from the sidelines, what have been your memorable moments of John Hutchinson over his 10-year career in the A-League with the Central Coast Mariners?
For me, seeing him captain the team to the grand final win, I know how much he wanted it. Saw how shattered he was when they lost against Brisbane on penalties. So to see him lift that trophy, I think no one deserved it more than him, and it was a great moment.
All right, tonight you're going to start as goalkeeper for the John Hutchinson 11 against the Central Coast Mariners. Are you going to try and get on the field? I know you love to score a goal. You scored a goal in the A-League. Will you score a goal here tonight?
I'll definitely try. I've spoken to Quaz to see whether or not he wanted to go in goals for me, and I'll go up front. So we'll see what happens. Hopefully, maybe last 10 minutes I get a run up front.
Danny Vukovic, good luck tonight.
Cheers. Thank you.
Central Coast Mariners former defender Patrick Swanswright joins me here pitch side. Patrick, a big night for the club.
Yeah, for the club, but I think more so for John Hutchinson and what is the he's achieved with the club, and being 10 years at one club is a massive achievement, and it's great to see a lot of old faders back and hopefully coming on the pitch.
When you look at the club and how much it's changed over 10 years, you saw Laurie McKenna's era, then you came in Graham Arnold's era and really shaped the club. But John Hutchinson had some tough times at that time as well.
Yeah, oh yeah, he would probably be the best one to speak to you about that. But I remember he wasn't classified as good enough in that time, and got a small gig in China, and went over and came back and worked so hard and tried to be there for the team as a team player he is, and sooner or later he worked himself back into the team, and that was probably the start for him to see that football is not always about an individual, but it's always about a team, and. Which he's always done in his former clubs, but then he really started to understand that and became the leader that he became when he got the captaincy.
And when you talk about the captaincy, season 7, you went on to win the Premier's Plate, and then season 8, it was all about the championship. What sort of leader was John Hutchinson through those times, and what did he do to this squad to take it to that next level?
Off the park, you mean? Because off the park, he was the best leader. He knew where we have to go out, and he knew what we have to do besides the football. But now on the park, he was the one that wanted to work hard. He knew he wasn't the most talented and technical player on the team, but he knew where his strength was, and that's where he always stayed. And he knew that he's good in getting the first ball, win the first ball. He couldn't win the first ball. He was trying to win the second balls. He was always trying to get players in the game that weren't in the game at that time or point of the game. And, yeah, he showed his leadership in not giving up after we go down 1-0 or 2-0 or 2-1. And he was always the one that, like, there's always a chance to come back, and there's always a chance to do something better the next moment. And that's what he took into the games every game.
And when you look at the young players who have come through the Central Coast Mariners over the last 5 years, the Matt Ryans, the Bernie Abinis, the Mile Jednak was even here with John Hutchinson. What sort of career development have they had under the leadership and the guile of John Hutchinson on and off the park?
I think then John wasn't the leader. I think he learned a lot of the older players back then, and that's what he was good at. He was also good knowing that he wasn't that leader yet, and he learned a lot of the players around. He learned a lot of probably me as a leader for in the centre defence, probably a lot of from Graham Arnold, what he's recognised like as a leader off the park, and then sooner or later became that leader in midfield, and he took all the things that he learned in the past, right, probably from year one till year 6 or 7. But he was very good and knew where his goals be and was going to be, and now he's a good thing that he's going to stay at the club in a different leadership role, and hopefully the club goes forward.
And just on yourself, you're still playing football, I believe, here on the Central Coast. How's that going? And what are you enjoying about playing park football now you're out of the professional ranks?
I do it just to give back to the community. I think I've been involved with the Mariners now for 4 years, 3 years as a player and 1 year as an NBL coach. And I think the club has given me a lot, but more so the supporters have given me a lot. And everything I did was always for the supporters and for the team. And yeah, so when that offer came to me, like, do you still want to play, park football? And with Dale Eggleton, who's a hero in the Central Coast, and with Nick Hagerstefanis, who's a good friend of mine from Fruit for All, so I thought, like, you know what, these guys deserve the compassion and my friendship, and I think if I can still play, I'll do it for them, and that's probably the only reason why I did it.
So what's Patrick Swanswright doing now, other than playing park football? Is he looking at coaching still, and do you think you've still got a career in football?
Oh yeah, very much so. I think I'll come back harder and better than before. I think I did very good with the NYL, with the Mariners, and developed a lot of players who now signed contracts with the Mariners youth team, with the first grade Mariners first grade, or with Dundee United, or with clubs overseas. So that was the only thing. My goal wasn't to win games. My goal was to produce players, and that's exactly what I did. And that's what a lot of other coaches and clubs have seen. So yeah, there's a big future for me ahead, and the only thing is I'll determine where I will be and when, because I'm not in a hurry. Doing my pro license hopefully in this year, coming year, and then we'll go and see where the future lies.
Patrick, thanks for joining us. Good luck tonight playing against the Central Coast Mariners.
Thank you, and see you tonight.
Joined by the Central Coast Mariners' first ever manager, now the mayor of Gosford, Laurie McKinna. Welcome to the John Hutchinson testimonial, and what a night it is for the captain of the Central Coast Mariners.
And it's a great night for everybody, you know, for the public, the fans, Hutch, and all these ex-players. They're loving it, you know. They've not seen some of them, not seen each other for 5-10 years, you know. So it's just fantastic, fantastic vibe up there, you know. The place is buzzing.
Now, you were the man who signed John Hutchinson first to the Central Coast Mariners, but you knew him beforehand at the Northern Spirit. What did John Hutchinson do that made you like him as a footballer?
He could play central midfield, left midfield, had a great left peg on him. He wasn't the quickest guy in the world, because that's because he carries a big arse about with him. But, you know, Hutch, he was just a good guy and a good team player, and I think that's been proved over the last 10 years. Like, Hutch has kept the dressing room together for 10 years.
And when you look at the Central Coast Mariners, 4 grand finals, John Hutchinson obviously missed the first one against Sydney FC, but then he stepped up to the plate in season 3, season 6, and then obviously season 8, the championship. That defined John Hutchinson's career.
Yeah, like when you're so close for so long, you have to win sometime. And just a pity I gave up coaching her, because I've still not won one. So, you know, but Hutch, seeing him on the field that day, I was behind the goals with my shirt off, swinging my shirt round about, and it was just great. Seeing like Wilco, you know, these guys actually gain something. They've been at the club for so long, and to finally get over the line was just great for the coast.
Now, when you think about John Hutchinson, you saw some of his finest hours, especially season 1, where he was one of the leading goal scorers in the competition with 7 goals. Is there a goal or a moment in John Hutchinson's career that stands out above any other?
I think the 2 goals against Sydney FC, you know, we got beat 3-2, but we came from behind, and like Hutch, one was left foot, one was right foot in the top corner. You know, the Spiders were running for cover, but I think those two just stand out in my mind, and their goals at Blue Tongue on that first season as well. He slotted one against, I can't remember if it was Newcastle, slotted in the far corner, but probably 2 against Sydney.
Do you think John Hutchinson and the Newcastle fans will ever get along?
Nah, and that's what's great about football. You know, there's a mutual respect for Hutch in Newcastle, but they don't like him, and that's great because he doesn't like them either.
And when you think of John Hutchinson, that probably defines the F3 derby, doesn't it, John Hutchinson? And maybe one day it could look to put John Hutchinson in a cup sort of thing when the F3 derby's on, because it just added so much tension to that game.
It did, and the person who, in my opinion, started the F3 hatred was Nick Merger, because he was the tackle on Angie Durante, and that's where it started. And I think maybe I helped along the lines when I said that when we go to Newcastle, we take thousands up there, and when they come down, they come in a minibus. And after that, thousands of the bastards came down.
And then you look around, and she said, there's so many people here to celebrate John Hutchinson's career, but Tommy Pondulak, Nick Merger, Adam Kwasnik, all there from day one. Just tell us some moments about Tommy Pondulak and Nick Merger on and off the field.
Merger was a clown off the field, but he was a good clown. On the field, he probably had the most ability in a player I've ever seen, but never fulfilled his potential because of injury. You know, he'd horrific knee injury, and that sums him up. One of the strongest players I've ever seen. Tom Pondulak could do anything. You know, he'd have 20 cigarettes before the game and still go and be a superstar. And he went on for years and went on to Melbourne Victory and done brilliant with them. But a class player. He'll start the game tonight, but he'll not last too long because he's got dodgy knees.
So you're coaching with Graham Arnold here tonight at Plume Park. What are your expectations from the John Hutchinson 11?
Well, it'll depend how many beers they've consumed before the start of the game. When I walked in and I saw the beers, it was beer o'clock. I thought, well, we're not going to be too competitive out here. But we've got 20 players, and it's going to be great to just, we'll be chopping and changing. And it could be a surprise in the third half. Because, as you know, Danny Vukovic rated himself as a striker, and Adam Kwasnik rates himself as a goalkeeper. So we're not giving away too much, but something might happen quite interesting in the third quarter.
Now, Laurie, the Central Coast Mariners don't have a great history of penalties. John Hutchinson tonight, will he take a penalty if they earn one late on?
Depends if I say he's allowed to take it, you know, because I'm the gaffer for the day. Hutch has told me that. Put the team on the park the way I see it. And so he doesn't have a choice in that. I'll pick it.
Formation, what are you playing?
4-2-3-1 to suit the players we've got. And the players starting is going to be Vukovic, Clark, Beauchamp, Osmond, Heffernan, Gooms, Hutch, Matt Simon, Kwasnik and Nick Merger. The boys all for year one are starting. We just thought that was a nice touch that starts a game, and they'll change pretty quick.
Lauren McKinna, enjoy tonight.
Cheers.
the man of the hour, John Hutchinson, joins me pitch side before kickoff in this match here this evening. John, congratulations on a wonderful career here at the Central Coast Mariners and also in the old National Premier League. You must be so excited to see so many old faces from your career back here this evening.
I think that's the main thing, really. It's just seeing people that I haven't seen in a long time. You know, like, let's say Tommy Pondiak, I haven't seen him since he left the Mariners. You know, we speak and a text message, but to see him again, it's unbelievable, you know. And every guy here that I've played with, I've got memories with, you know, and it's been fantastic.
When you look over the 10 seasons here at the Central Coast Mariners, Lauren McKenna was the man who brought you here to the club. What do you owe Lauren McKenna for the last 10 years of your professional career and your personal life as well?
Yeah, look, I think it goes back from the 10 years. You know, I was at Northern Spirit when Laurie came, and, you know, I was enjoying my career at the time, and Laurie pretty much told me it was a make or break. He gave me 2 weeks from there, and then, you know, I've known Laurie for about 15 years. So, you know, you talk about owing him enough for the A-League, I owe him more than that. You know, he's a great mentor, a great friend, you know, and even when he wasn't here, he always spoke to me, helped me out. You know, I'm moving into coaching and he's giving me advice, him and Graham Arnold as well, you know, both great people, great mentors. But, you know, Laurie's done a lot for me. I'm just excited. I'm just excited by the amount of people to hear, all the boys. And, yeah, so it's going to be an unbelievable game.
And there's going to be a crowd of around 2,500 people here at Plume Park, the home of Central Coast football. You've been here many a times on cold nights playing against Central Coast Mariners 11s and also playing against the local sides. What's it mean to play here at Plume Park in your final game of your professional career?
I think just playing here is more of what we're about, the Mariners, a family like setting. And, you know, for Kate and myself, we want to make it affordable for families just to come down and not just enjoy my last game, but, you know, there's people like Matt Simon, Zach Anderson, Brent Griffiths, Tommy Slater, people that won't be at the club next season, you know, and it's a chance for the fans to say thank you to them and the boys to say thanks to the fans and members and just people, you know. We wanted to make it more of a family atmosphere and make sure everyone enjoyed it. I know my team's going to enjoy the occasion. They're pretty pumped about just being together and playing a game of football. You know, people flying in from Perth, Melbourne, Adelaide, some from Canberra, but, you know, a big mention to Chris Doig, who came out from the UK. You know, he's... arrived the other morning. The worst part about it was 5 a.m. pickup I had to get him. But apart from that, it's great to have him here.
And when you talk about Kate and the family, it'll allow you to spend more time with them. But you're still going to be coaching. So what's Kate said to you about post-playing career and about what you have to do at home now?
Yeah, it's more busy being a coach and player. You know, I've been in the job now 4 weeks with Tony Walmsley. And, you know, I'm very grateful that Tony's given me an opportunity to be assistant coach under his guidance. And, you know, he didn't have to do that, but, you know, I'm so grateful and looking forward to the opportunity. I'm pumped about that. I've been having long days, but, you know, Kate understands, and that's, you know, that's what they say the better half's for. So, you know, I've got two kids and my wife, and they understand, you know, that, you know, I've got football and it's my passion. And, you know, like I've said in past, like the women, like my wife, had to give up a lot, you know. She had to give up her dream for me to chase my dream, and now I'm still chasing my other dream, and she's, you know, looking after the kids. So it takes a great woman to do that.
So when you talk about your coaching career, what do you have to do now to separate yourself from the club captain to now an assistant coach?
Yeah, it's been tough, you know. It's, you know, I see the boys mucking around and joking about, you know, stuff that I'd normally be in there joking with them, and I've got to stand back and just accept that it's, I can't do that no more, you know. Of course we can have jokes and, you know, I'll muck around as much as anyone else, but, you know, I've got to let the boys do their own thing now. You know, they've got to build their own culture, set their own rules, do their own standards, you know. Me and Tony will run our side of it, the staff side of it, and under Tony's guidance we'll make sure it's, you know, what the club's about. But the boys have to move forward now, you know. It's I've got to step away, let them build their own culture and build their own stuff. But, you know, under Monty's guidance and Liam Reddy and Eddie Bosner and Josh Rose, you know, the club's in safe hands. You know, they've been around long enough to know what the club's about, and the challenge is going to be massive next season. You know, we can't hide away from that, but what we do promise next season, we'll play entertaining football and we'll do what the Mariners have always done for 10 years, and we'll have a go.
And you speak about the people up there, but they helped you win your ultimate goal, and that was the championship in Season 8. Just talk us about Season 8 and how memorable it was in your playing career.
Season 8 was, look, for me, it was my best footballing season. I thought I played my best football in Season 8. I played with some fantastic footballers as well. You know, I think over 10 years, that's probably the best team you know, one of the best teams A-League's seen. You know, we obviously had the Brisbane team that went 36 undefeated, which was a fantastic feat and a great team. But, you know, we would rival that team. You know, we were very good. And 19 years of pro football, I won one grand final. You know, so I'll treasure that grand final forever. And, you know, I always talk to the boys about it and say how much it means to you as a footballer. The only thing that, you know, is disappointing that day was that Matt Simon and Alex Wilkinson weren't a part of that. You know, they're two guys that bled yellow and blue for a long time, and for them not to be there on that special day is the only setback that we've got for that day.
And then finally, tonight, lots of old players out there. Tommy Pondulak, are you a bit worried about him getting on the field here this evening? Nick Merger as well, is he going to get injured?
I think there might be a few injuries. I'm a bit worried about myself as well. I haven't trained in 4 weeks. So, yeah, look, it's, you know, obviously the boys will just rotate on and off. Tommy's Tommy. Nothing's changed with Tommy. He turned up in the laid-back attitude that Tommy has, and you never know what he's going to do. But, you know, Nick Merger's flown over from Perth, and Rostin Griffiths, Danny Vukovic, all from Perth, you know. And to see so many people make such an effort, you know, it's incredible. I feel lost for words sometimes, you know. I've seen all the boys walking in, and it's an unbelievable feeling. So I'm just looking forward to having a game with them and then obviously having a glass of water at full time with them.
Are you on penalty duty here tonight?
Mate, I can't hit a penalty. You're joking. You see my penalty in the grand final against Brisbane? It snuck in, but, you know, I think Theo almost jumped over the ball. So I don't think the boys will let me on pens, to be honest. I think Quaz or Petrovsky or someone like that will definitely want the limelight, so they can step up for the pen and take it.
John, enjoy your night.
Thank you, mate.
Welcome to the John Hutchison testimonial match. 10 years at the Central Coast Mariners, where John Hutchison gets to handpick a team to take on the Central Coast Mariners. Joining myself, Trent Dickerson, here at Plume Park is Luke Byrne. Luke, what a special occasion at the home of football for the Central Coast.
Yeah, good evening, Trent, and what a fantastic occasion it is to be here to celebrate John Hutchison's professional career ending here at the Central Coast Mariners after 10 long seasons of hard work. The home of Central Coast football is proud enough to celebrate John Hutchison and an outstanding professional career.
268 matches for the Mariners. That's just unbelievable. 10 years at the club. We've been lucky enough to witness nearly all of those matches for John Hutchison at our time at Coast FM, and to be rewarded with a testimonial match. I can't think of how many have been done in the A-League already. I think this would have to be one of the first that have been done. And it's a really special night for everyone that's going to be out here, all the former players, but John Hutchison, the man, 10 years. Some of your special memories of John Hutchison over that time.
What a fantastic career it's been for John Hutchison, Trent. When you think about John Hutchison, you think about that grand final win, don't you, against the Western Sydney Wanderers down there at the Sydney Football Stadium, an outstanding occasion for the football club, the people of the Central Coast, and John Hutchison himself. It was coming back from the end after two seasons ago when Graham Arnold, then coach, said to John Hutchison he didn't think he'd make the team. He went over to China, then he came back and fought for his place here at the Central Coast Mariners, and what an outstanding achievement it was. Number two for mine is the F3 derbies against the Newcastle Jets. Those games were fantastic, and John Hutchison, over 10 years of football, was in amongst it nearly all the time. I felt sorry for him that he missed his final F3 derby after Phil Moss didn't use him in that game, but John Hutchison, the Newcastle fans, what a relationship they shared over 10 years of football. And then finally, that goal this season against Melbourne City down there in Melbourne. The Mariners were struggling. John Hutchison steps up, gets the result, and the Central Coast Mariners draw 2-2. But it was just a fantastic strike from outside the area. They went and jumped each other like they'd won the grand final, and that was a crowning moment in John Hutchison's professional career for mine.
I go back to the grand final loss to the Brisbane Roar in Brisbane, the night 2-2 into the penalty shootout. And after that match, John Hutchison, in the tunnels underneath Lang Park, Suncorp Stadium, in tears, in absolute tears, just crying because of that loss. And that's how much it meant to him. And that's how much more effort he was prepared to put in for himself to ensure that he stayed in that team and saw himself through to a championship.
Yeah, well, that was heartbreak, wasn't it? After the game, I remember walking past John Hutchison looking for an interview pitch side, and he just waved at me and said, "No, thank you, Luke. I can't talk to you right now," because he was just in tears. He was sobbing on the pitch. I've never seen someone react like that. And it was probably his reaction that set the Mariners apart for the next two seasons of A-League football. Season 7, they were fantastic, winning the premiership, led by John Hutchison, taking over from his good friend Alex Wilkinson as the captain of the Central Coast Mariners. And then season 8, it was all John Hutchison, Daniel McBreen, the senior players, Patrick Swanswick as well, stepping up, taking the Mariners to that next level and ensuring the Central Coast Mariners won their first championship.
Let's talk quickly about that relationship with the fans. Of course, people up the F3, up in Newcastle, love to hate John Hutchison. Was great for the league and also other fans around the country. Also, not always a rosy relationship with his own fans. A couple of times, some rocky times, but they pulled through that, and the Central Coast locals learned to love him as much as away teams love to hate him.
Yeah, John Hutchinson was always one of those players that the other fans hated, and they would love him on their team because he gave 110% for the Central Coast Mariners every time he walked onto the field. His relationship with the Jets and the squadron was unbelievable. All the tantrums that the fans chanted, all the sayings that they were giving to John Hutchinson throughout his professional career. It was amazing to see the coin-throwing incidents of Season 3 just took it to another level. John Hutchinson loved the Newcastle fans because they hated him so much. And the Central Coast Mariners fans, at times, they lost faith in John Hutchinson, but they came back and pulled through. And his performances in Season 6, 7 and 8 lifted him to another level. And now he's the much-loved captain of this football club.
The transition to coaching. John Hutchinson, from player to coach, leaves the players' dressing room, enters the coach's dressing room. What has to change with John Hutchinson to make him a success? Often we see it, players turning from playing into coaching. Sometimes it's successful, a la Kevin Muscat, sometimes not so successful. What will John Hutchinson have to do here at the Mariners to make the transition successful?
You'll have to step away, obviously, from the players, won't you? You'll need to be a leader in that club inside the dressing room as a coach, though, and support Tony Walmsley. Obviously, he's going to have to make some decisions which players are just not happy about. But that's the job of a coach. And with Tony Walmsley at the helm, John Hutchinson, his assistant, I'm sure the Mariners are in safe hands going forward for Season 11 in the A-League.
And to talk briefly about the Team of the Decade, we'll announce it very shortly on the broadcast. But this Team of the Decade, some special players have come back to celebrate this evening with John Hutchinson.
Unfortunately, though, some players are not here from the Team of the Decade because of European commitments. But you look at the players like the Mile Sturjoskis, the Bernie Abinis, the Danny Vukovicis, the Patrick Svonsvikes, the Tom Pondulaks of the Central Coast Mariners. They're here tonight. What an occasion it's going to be here at Plume Park. And we can celebrate football here on the Central Coast.
We'll be bringing the teams to you very shortly here on the broadcast of the John Hutchinson testimonial match, John Hutchinson 11 versus the Central Coast Mariners.
And welcome to Plume Park here at on the central coast of New South Wales. Just getting a little bit of fold back here at the moment in our ears, but we'll live with that at the moment. As the John Hutchinson 11 is about to take on the Central Coast Mariners 11 in front of a bumper crowd here on the central coast of New South Wales. The crowd has been streaming in all afternoon, and it's finally built up to its crescendo, only a few minutes away from kickoff. What a lineup we're in store for here tonight. The two teams, well, the Central Coast Mariners have had such an indifferent season this year. Last night, the Mariners medal was awarded, and they are looking to finish the year, the season, on a high. John Hutchinson 11, it's a who's who of former players, and we'll go through those all very shortly. Joining me in commentary tonight for this match will be Michael Komet. And Michael, tonight's match, it's a celebration of the success of John Hutchinson.
Good evening, Trent. Good evening, viewers out there. It is a massive celebration tonight, and what an occasion. And we just saw the players warm up just previously there, some of the old legends, and led to believe that the starting lineup will be the Season 1 squad. So I'm very much looking forward to it. They haven't changed a lot. Look at Dean Heffernan, Michael Beauchamp, some of those players. They look as fit and healthy as they did from Season 1 in those Mariners days.
And joining us on the touchline for tonight's match will be Coast FM regular and on the stream tonight, Luke Byrne. Looking forward to this match, Luke. So many familiar faces.
Yeah, good evening, Trent. Good evening, Michael. And good evening to all our viewers. What a fantastic occasion here at Plume Park at Lisro for John Hutchinson's testimonial. What a stellar career he has had at the Central Coast Mariners. And looking at his team tonight, what a team he has. And think about the reserves list and looking at Mile Sturjoski, Bernie Abini, walking past me right now, even the legend himself, Tony Vidmar. What a team is in store for this match.
Let's have a look at tonight's lineups here this evening between these two teams, the Central Coast Mariners and the John Hutchinson 11, and some such familiar faces there on that team sheet. We'll start with the Central Coast Mariners. Liam Reddy, Storm Rue, Joshua Rose, newly crowned Coast FM Fruit for All Player of the Season, Jacob Poscolero, Zach Anderson, Nick Montgomery, Anthony Caceres, who last night was awarded the Mariners Medal for the best player of the season, John Nick Fitzgerald, Glenn Trefiro, Eddie Bosner, and Fabio Ferreira, making up the starting 11 for the Central Coast Mariners, of course, coached by Tony Walmsley. Having a look at the John Hutchison 11, and he certainly remembered all the great players in selecting this team here tonight. Danny Vukovic in goal, Andrew Clark, Michael Beauchamp, Dean Heffernan, and Matt Osman making up the defensive lineup here this evening. Andre Gumprick, Tom Ponulak, Adam Kwasnik, Matt Simon with 162 appearances himself for the Central Coast Mariners, Nick Merger, and of course the skipper of the Hutchison 11, John Hutchison, 268 appearances for the Central Coast Mariners.
A league record, of course. That'll soon be eclipsed maybe next season by Danny Vukovic, who's out there with the Hutch 11 as well. And as you can see there, the who's who of past players, some great faces in the lineups there. I'm told tonight, Trent, there's three 25-minute thirds. Some of the players there probably can only last 5 to 10 minutes at the most. Tommy Pondlinyak, very excited to see him there. He has bad knees, and been told during the week that Andre Gumprick has injured himself as well, so he'll have limited time on the park.
Andre Gumprick preparing for this match this evening. The two teams just having their customary pre-match shots for the souvenirs for the press. What a solid crowd in attendance looking around this field here in Lizaro, spiritual home of Central Coast football. And it's such a... they've all turned up here tonight. 2,500 tickets sold before the match. Some 200 only available at the gate. Capped crowd here tonight. And all those tickets were sold.
Yeah, it was fantastic to see the Central Coast football public out in force to support John Hutchison here at Plume Park. As you said, the spiritual home of football here. And it's absolutely packed out there. Told that the ground has a record around 4,000, but it was capped at 2,500 today just for the viewing experience. And the pitch, as you can see out there, it is absolutely immaculate. So expecting some good football, a bit of fun tonight as well.
Certainly will be some fun, and some players in the team shot for the Central Coast Mariners, which will probably be their last time in a Mariners jersey before they move on for next season.
You see Zach Anderson there, Brent Griffiths, two of the players we know moving on. Be sad to see them go, but Mariners are moving onwards, hopefully, and upwards for next season under new coach Tony Walmsley.
Ross and Griffiths, of course, playing in the Hutch 11 as well, so the siblings up against each other here this evening.
Yeah, and I don't think it's really happened for a while now, the two brothers up against each other. Bit of rivalry there, and the Hutch 11 playing a 4-2-3-1 formation as well. Roston in that holding midfield role with John Hutchison. That'll certainly be a formidable, two formidable opponents for Glenn Trefiro, who'll be playing the number 10 position tonight.
For those of you that like all the stats, it'll be Stephen Lucas who will be the referee. Lance Greenshields and Thomas Lee will be our assistants for tonight's match. The Hutch 11 will get us underway very shortly. Nick Merger over the football, making a dash up the left-hand side. Dean Heffernan looking for the ball. I'm sure he's made sure his hair is just perfect for tonight's match as referee Stevens Lucas gets us underway.
Dean Heffernan with the ball there. He's playing State League at the moment, him and Michael Beauchamp, both at the same club, so there'll be a little bit of a combination going there.
So now is the Hutch 11 take up as much possession as possible to start it off with, and they go all the way back to Danny Vukovic in goal. And of course, Danny Vukovic is, well, we know, slouch out there for the Hutch 11, currently still plying his trade at the Perth Glory. For how much longer is a question. But at the moment, the ball's staying with the team in blue as they go all the way back now across towards Michael Beauchamp, who will look towards his midfield. And there's a skipper with his first touch of the evening, John Hutchison, coming out of the midfield.
Tommy Ponliak and Andre Gumprick both getting nice touches on the ball there in the centre of midfield. Two players very well known for their ability on the ball, their technical ability.
Tonight, Luke Byrne will be grabbing interviews with players on the bench as well as goal scorers after they've happened here this evening. So to bring to you the comments from the players straight after the action's occurred, as we see the Hutch 11 move up the right-hand side. Screaming for the ball coming to the centre was Tom Ponulak. He felt himself lucky and thought that it was his chance to take that ball in the opening few minutes. Perhaps he hasn't got the full 75 minutes in him. As we see the first attacking header loop over the crossbar. Liam Reddy in the unfamiliar long pants here this evening.
Yeah, first opportunity of the game, and it's Adam Kwasnik on the header there, and just went wide. It was a good cross down the right-hand side. This game certainly... Oh, look at Liam Reddy go. He's away here, Trent.
Liam Reddy, what can he do? He almost gets pushed over the touchline. He's almost up towards halfway here. Liam Reddy, in fact, he's over halfway. He's been pulled back in a long-range effort laid on by the Mariners through Storm Roo off his right foot.
And now Danny Vukovic is away.
Danny Vukovic is going to try and match the theatrics there of Liam Reddy. He's got to about the same distance up the field and released the ball on the right-hand side. And now here's Joe Marston medal winner, Tom Ponulak, of course, who tries to chip Liam Reddy. Liam Reddy well on his line and having none of that. And it's easy to forget that after the Mariners, Tom Ponulak went down to the Melbourne Victory and had such success down there in some of the glory days of the Melbourne Victory.
Absolutely. He's fondly remembered in his days at the Mariners, an exceptional player. You saw there his knees didn't really have the power to put any effort onto that shot because of his knees. Chipping Liam Reddy when Liam Reddy's sitting on the line. It's a pretty ambitious thing.
Now we see the Hutch 11 up and over halfway. They move towards the right-hand side again. Can the cross be whipped in here by Matt Simon? It is in the centre. It's easily dealt with, though, by the professional defensive line. And it'll come out through the newly crowned Nick Montgomery, who is the skipper for the Mariners for next season, which was announced. And the handing over of the captain's armband to become just the fifth team captain of the Mariners.
Fantastic choice, too. He's a hard player, Nick Montgomery. He's an exceptional leader. It'll be seamless, the transition from John Hutchinson into Nick Montgomery.
In fact, the fourth, I should say, after Noel Spencer, Alex Wilkinson, and then John Hutchinson.
So it's not a bad effort, is it? Only four captains in 10 seasons of A-League history for the Mariners.
Might cross down to Luke Byrne, who's down the touchline here, though, that Matt Simon takes the ball on the right-hand side here. Matt Simon into the penalty area, up against Reddy, crosses the centre. It was a real opportunity there, gone begging out the back. Ponulak was also looking for it. And it's away to the centre of the field. One would describe the match speed so far, Malcolmette, as perhaps pedestrian?
Very pedestrian, not A-League standard. Very much so. But Nick Merger was streaming through the middle there as quick as he possibly could. Just couldn't get it out at the end of that Matt Simon cross.
Didn't want to injure himself, no doubt.
No, not at all.
Especially the fishing handle. Luke Byrne down on the touchline.
I'm here with Mille Sojoski. Mille, a very slow start to the John Hutchinson testimonial.
It's been a slow start, but I think our team's been dominating, to be honest. Had a few chances, and it's looking good.
Goalkeeper's getting forward. You like seeing that?
Yeah, it makes it exciting. You know, I think they've had a good run, but we'll see how the game goes.
You retired at the end of last season. How have you pulled up after 12 months without football?
You know, I haven't done too much, but I think coaching the kids in my academy has kept me reasonably fit, so I'm looking forward to getting on the pitch.
And John Hutchinson, what do you have to say about the man here tonight?
He's a great guy, you know. He's everything that the Mariners is all about. You know, he's been here from day one, and, there's no better man to represent the club, in my opinion.
Now, looking for you to go onto the pitch here this evening, looking at Tom Ponulak probably in particular. He looks like 5-10 minutes might do him. Are you looking to get into the action pretty quickly?
Yeah, definitely. You know, I want to play, but I'm the same. You know, I probably played 10-minute spurts, and that's enough for me.
Miller said, Joshy, thanks for joining us here on the stream.
Cheers, mate. Thank you.
There was Luke Byrne down on the touchline with Mille Sojoski. The ball now away with Dean Heffernan.
Oh, we're used to these runs, aren't we, by Dean Heffernan?
Down that left-hand side, and most recently, of course, of the Western Sydney Wanderers, Dean Heffernan, being held up by Poscolero across on the right-hand side now. Nick Merger standing on the football and is dispossessed by Joshua Rose there. He's going to take it away now. Up towards halfway, and Nick Merger had so much talent to give the A-League and just was just broke down at all the wrong times during his time at the Mariners.
Absolutely. We heard in the pre-game interview with Laurie McKenna, who's probably, in Laurie's eyes, one of the most talented players to ever come in Mariners colours and offered a lot. And the times we did see Nick Merger on the park, super goal scorer, some great memories, earned him a Socceroos cap. He's away here, Nick Fitzgerald.
We see the ball. You think there was an appeal for offside that was waved away on the left-hand side. The Mariners want to build up from here now. Finding a way through, not able to do so.
Very compact defence, isn't it, Trent?
Yes, they're all can throw a sheet over them at the moment. The ball finally across on the left-hand side. They'll now make their way towards the penalty area with Ferreira. A few little step-overs. Sitting on the top of the penalty area. Oh, a neat little back heel now out onto the left-hand side. And you can see the player's breaths out there. And finally, it breaks down. And it will be a goal kick for the Hutch. 11-0 all the score here. Coming up into 8 minutes played.
Adam Kwasnik putting out Matt Simon. He's got plenty of space down this right-hand side. Not marked at all.
It's Matt Simon. He'll be one that they'll want to watch. He'll have plenty of running in him here tonight. We do see the player into the penalty area in Merger. He strikes into the defender. Thought he could have pulled the trigger. I think he was looking for the penalty call there. Didn't forthcome. And now it's with Simon. Puts a ball back into that densely packed penalty area. And eventually it'll come away now. Searching ball. Nobody will be able to get there in the end. For the Mariners, and the Hutch 11 will turn it away.
Nick Merger of the old days would have certainly got onto that ball a lot quicker. Certainly lost a lot of pace. Hasn't even been out of the game for a while over there in Perth. But still used his body strength very well to engineer that opportunity.
Ponyolak now. In towards the penalty area. Fed in. No run forthcoming. And it's going to be the goal kick now here. In fact, offside there.
Yeah, it was a lovely ball by Andre Gumprick. Dean Heffernan just encroaching down that left-hand side.
It's Kwasnik also looking hungry there. We see the boys in yellow bring the ball away. Now it's with Montgomery. Comes across and looking towards Trefiro. One more time on the right-hand side. It's a ball down this right side. Rue will want this. Getting some good practice on his right foot here, Storm Rue. Trefiro now. Bosner lining one up. Files it. All spilt by Vukovic. A-League player on A-League player there. Had a long time of looking at it there, Danny Vukovic. Low down to his left. Striking the chest and getting away with it that time.
Plenty of time to wind up, didn't he, Eddie Bosner? What was he doing so far forward from the centre-back position? And in the end, it was difficult as it was skidding for Danny Vukovic.
Ball being fed here now. We'll find Merger. Merger off the left, and it's a soft shot from the former Socceroo. And we just see Liam Reddy clear the ball straight into his own defenders. Simon comes through on the volley. Missing by a fair margin there. Approaching 10 minutes and some of the boys in the blue shirts might be sucking in the big ones now. Might cross down to Luke Byrne. He's down there on the field.
Yeah, it's been a pretty slow start. I'm going to be joined by Tony Walmsley quickly from the Central Coast Mariners. Tony, what are you looking to get out tonight other than celebrate Hutch's career?
It's about celebrating Hutch's career. You know, it's nothing more than that. The crowd want to be entertained, so hopefully as the night goes on, we can start to score a few goals and maybe they can pop one or two in as well. Maybe if we can get Liam Reddy forward a little bit more, we might have more of a chance.
Are you looking to put Liam Reddy up forward in the third period of this game?
Well, I haven't thought about that, but it's probably a good idea, and maybe you should join the technical team with that advice like that.
That would be a good idea. Now, just looking at Eddie Bosner, is he got a license to shoot from anywhere tonight?
He was just nearly killed by Liam Reddy about 5 minutes ago, so here we go. I think we're just about to be a goal out.
Tommy Ponyolak, real crowd favourite. He puts a Hutch 11 one ahead. Liam Reddy coming well out of his penalty area. And Tom Ponyolak receives a pass there from Matt Simon. Players at different ends of their career when they were together at the Mariners. And Tom Ponyolak adds to another goal to his Mariners.
Great goal, Tom Pondula. Great start to this game.
Yeah, now it's just park the bus and hope for the best, yeah?
Hope for the best?
Yeah, that's it, hope for the best.
Tom Pondulak there.
Tom Pondulak with Luke Byrne down there on the touchline, receiving the ball from Simon and able to tap it away easily.
Yeah, Tommy P, just as he did in that final against Adelaide in Season 1, got the early goal. The Mariners held on to get through to the grand final. He was in the right place at the right time. Good work by Matty Simon. He's basically been left unchecked by Joshua Rose's whole game, and he put a cross across. Liam Reddy really wants that striker's position, doesn't he?
Well, that'll add to Tom Pondulak's, I guess, 9 goals that he scored in Mariners colours. Goes up to 10 now in quasi-Mariners colours as the Hutch 11 leads the Mariners 1-0. 12 minutes gone in the first of the 3 periods.
I wonder how he feels, Trent, about wearing sky blue, given the rivalry that the Mariners had in Melbourne Victory. Had
well, I heard
against Sydney FC.
John Hutchison was filthy when he saw the colour of the jerseys.
I'm sure he was.
Into the centre again. They're making offer here, and it's going to be another goal put on by the Hutch 11. Make it 2, rack them up. This time it's Safidi on the left hand side, and it's Sasho Petroski who gets it for the Hutch 11. Sasho Petroski is the will get some words from.
He's taking his shirt off.
The marksman here.
Sash, first touch of the ball, was it?
Second, mate, second, yeah. I had to get a feel of things. It's a bit wet and dewy, so yeah.
Good goal, Sasha Petroski.
17th goal in Mariners colours. 16, of course, I think he picked up the first Mariners hat-trick too, Sasha Petroski.
In A-League, yes. So Nicky Merger, of course, in the pre-season tournament. Club World Challenge, got a hat-trick against Brisbane, I'm led to believe.
So the Mariners kick off once again up against the Hutch 11, and it's 2-0. They lead the Mariners, the Hutch 11, and Liam Reddy has been found out twice so far in tonight's match.
Well, I don't think he could have done much about that second one, Trent. It was a lovely cross by Vuko Tomasevich and Sasha Petroski. Both of them didn't start. I didn't see him come on. And all of a sudden, there's a combination there for a goal.
Bit now left-hand side for error. Two go out. Simon's one. Vukovic is awake on his near post. Dressed in the all pink here tonight. Not going to get caught out. His clearance, though, is a poor one. Montgomery will be happy for that.
I wonder how long before pride kicks in a little bit for this Mariners team, and they'll lift the gear.
Caceres now. Newly crowned Mariners medalist. The 10th in the club's history. A beanie now for the Hutch 11. Fresh from that grand final loss to Sydney FC. Tomasevich, surprise call up for the Hutch 11. One season at the Mariners, 06-07, 17 appearances for Vuko Tomasevich.
Actually made his debut on this ground against the Central Coast 11 as well.
You see a beanie down on the left-hand side. Puts on his right boot. Nicely to the centre, top of the penalty area, drive 3-0, make it 3.
Andre Gumprecht.
Shut the door, there is Andre Gumprecht getting the goal. He said he only had 5 minutes in him. He's made the most of it in opening the door and going after it. And we'll be able to cross down to Luke Byrne very shortly to speak to the German national.
Andre, what a strike, one of your best.
Yeah, it was actually, mate. And I was waiting a long period of time for it too.
Play. It's a quality strike by Andre Gumprecht. First time, just smacked into the back of the net. I know he's still keeps himself very fit, Andre Gumprecht. He's at the International Football School there as one of the coaches and leads a very healthy lifestyle, and he looks in good shape out there.
Well, so fit, I believe he's injured himself training for this match, getting himself
against
right.
The kids.
Yes, strained a calf muscle. To see Petroski. Oh, I think that might be the first free kick of the evening. Stephen Lucas sticks a hand up. Matt Simon not happy. Has he ever been happy, though, in conceding a free kick?
Never.
In the centre now. Towards. It's been fed through nicely. Quickly off his line, though. Vukovic. Well, for a match that started off at pedestrian pace for the first 8 minutes or so, Mohamed, it's been a flurry of goals to the outgoing John Hutchison side. And there might be some more to come. I think Matt Simon's trying to see Liam Reddy off his line there and have a pot shot. Get a good shot of how many, all the crowd that are braving the cool weather here at Lizaro tonight.
It's actually quite pleasant. It's not your typical plume where it's close to 0 degrees and the fog's coming in. It's going to be quite hot tonight, so fortunate for everyone who's come out here.
Liam Reddy taking advantage of a ball boy there to throw the ball into him. Good on him. Try and take the 12th man when you're 3-0 down in the first half.
Need it. Maybe get some boots on the young lad.
Absolutely. The Mariners at the moment across the face looking forward. They do want to save some face here, you can imagine. It's away again. Look to be Stojowski. Stojowski once again. Abini in the centre. What can Stojowski do? He's going to feed Abini into the penalty area here. He'll use Stojowski once again off the left boot. It's a poor ball, but it will probably find Matt Simon. It does. Now Abini is chasing it at half pace. I think he's coming down to the speed of his teammates. Tomasevic now back to Stojowski. Again, the former Socceroo going wide of the Liam Reddy goal.
It's Wollongong these days, Milo Stojowski. He's got his own football school down there, academy that he runs. Plenty of coaching clinics. I know some of the Mariners players in the holidays regularly go down there and help him out with that.
And then Scott Chipperfield, from the same Wollongong area. Similar lengths of career. Scott Chipperfield now, of course, a resident of Switzerland.
Alvin Checkerly, an ex-Mariners player as well.
Absolutely.
He's a Wollongong boy. There's good breeding ground for football. Paul O'Grady spends plenty of time down there as well.
Ferreira and Rue trying to team up there. It'll be a throw now. Put in for the Hutch 11. Might just cross down to Luke Byrne down there on the touchline.
Yeah, just getting into the dugout here of the Hutch 11. I'm going to grab Dean Heffernan down here just very quickly if I can. Dean, a great start to the Hutch 11 here this evening.
Yeah, it's been really good actually. See some of the greats like Andre Gumprecht and Sash score a goal. So, and Nick Merger putting on a show for everyone.
What has John Hutchison meant to the Central Coast Mariners over 10 years?
Oh, look, I think, you know, it's pretty obvious that he's been, you know, the heart and soul of the team. And, you know, everyone's just happy to be here for him and put on a, you know, a good night.
What are you doing with yourself these days?
Yeah, not much, eh?
Not much? You're still playing football, kicking around somewhere?
I'll be playing here tomorrow. Play for Bankstown City Lions with Megsy here and another former Mariner is our coach, Leo Cull. So we'll be playing at 3 o'clock here tomorrow and, yeah, that's about it. Got a little gym and things like that going as well, so.
Well done, Hef. Good to see you out there. Hopefully you get out there soon.
Thanks, mate. Cheers.
Dean Heffernan down there with Luke Byrne.
Wouldn't want to injure himself tonight, would he? Him or Michael Houchon? There'd be conspiracy theories at Bankstown if that's the case.
What about Leo Carl being the coach?
It's indeed.
Learn to juggle the ball at the moment with the Mariners. They want to get one back before the end of the first period, coming up to the last 5 minutes of that period, and they haven't been able to breach the Vukovic goal. And Abini away down this left-hand side, and this will be a chase here for Zach Anderson. He'll know he's in a foot race up against Bernie Abini. Top of the penalty area, Petroski. His shot is smothered. We'll have our first corner of the evening for the Hutch 11.
Don't expect anything less from Sasha Petroski. We know how goal-hungry he was. He's always on the ball, always looking to shoot, and showed exactly there. Got the second goal, but him and Brent Griffiths having a chat, or are they having an altercation? Looks like a little bit of altercation. There you go.
Sasha's asking for a program to see who's marking him.
Oh.
The ball at the moment down on the post, and Liam Reddy down there quickly.
He got ahead of Brent Griffiths there, didn't he? He got the header on the ball, just hit the post. Could have easily been four there for the Hutch 11.
So a few boys will be looking forward to the first break, the first of three periods here this evening. With Trent Dickerson, Mohamed and Luke Byrne as we bring you the live stream of the Hutch 11 versus the Central Coast Mariners 11 with thanks to Central Coast Leagues Club. It's Fitzgerald. He draws in two. Oh, Fitzgerald puts on some skills. He thinks he's playing for a shirt. Eventually, the Hutch 11 put the ball out over the goal line. It will be the first corner of the match for the Mariners.
Big solid tackle there by Patrick Swanzwijk. Wouldn't expect anything less from him. He was one of the best tacklers in the game during his time in the A-League. There's no doubt about that.
Of course, still kicking the ball, as we heard before the match, for the in the Central Coast Premier League. Oh, Liam Reddy is tackling a player well outside his penalty area. Shot on goal, headed off the line by the Mariners. Play on was a call from referee Stephen Lucas. He saw enough advantage in that.
It's in his genes, isn't it, Liam Reddy? With his old man there.
The ball on the right-hand side. Fabio Ferreira into the penalty area. Delivers across. Fitzgerald looking for a goal. Swanzwijk clears it.
It was actually appealing for handball.
I thought there was a little handball in there as well.
Looked to touch a handball, but the referee's... He's going to let a rugby tackle go. He probably decided to let that one go as well.
You see Abini up against Anderson. Abini still. Being back now, Tomasevic. One more time. Swanzwijk.
Weeks now since the Mariners players out there have had a game. They've been doing their coaching license as well. So they haven't been really training that hard. They'd be feeling it, I think... Not as much as the boys in blue out there, but they'd be certainly feeling it out there.
Glenn Trefiro, whose brother, looking for a job now. Got cut by the Western Sydney Wanderers and the So, who got cut from the Wanderers a couple of weeks ago.
Yeah, that was massive, the Wanderers. Massive rebuilding for them.
Ball here now with the Hutch 11 again. They are up 3-0. Top of the penalty area. Cut back across. Now Abini with the ball at his feet. Received it from Petroski. Petroski again. Fitted on a nice little back heel here. It's stuck in the near post there by Roston Griffiths. The number 11, Roston Griffiths, makes it 4. And there's going to be a mountain of work to do for the Mariners in the last two periods of this game.
Lucky deflection?
That is all played for. I knew Zaki was going to throw himself at that and played off his foot.
Are you a bit worried about your brother on the other side?
He's in the size of him. He looks like an animal these days, so he's always been known for a strong tackle.
Go well.
Thanks, mate.
Roston Griffiths still standing like he was sucking the big ones in.
I know. Well, he hasn't played for a few weeks now as well. It's a little bit of deflection there, as you can see. A very lucky deflection. Beat Liam Reddy on the near post. Doesn't often happen.
No goalkeeper likes to get beaten on the near post, do they?
Absolutely not.
You see the Mariners shoot from outside the penalty box, and I think that Danny Vigovic will be happy to see them coming from that range all evening. Abini now over halfway. Petroski making the run. Goes way out the right-hand side. Back into the far side of the penalty area. First time Petroski shoots off the left. Channeling the former days of Sydney FC and, of course, the Mariners as well.
Newcastle Jets, maybe not Newcastle Jets. Wasn't as prolific at the Jets as he was certainly at the Mariners or at Sydney FC. He had a fine A-League career and before that a fine National League career as well, Sasha Petroski. Scored plenty of goals in his time. He's was an outstanding striker.
And that is the end of the first period, according to referee Stephen Lucas. Like a short break here from Plume Park. And when we come back, Luke Byrne will have someone to interview after the first period. The Central Coast Mariners trail the Hutch 11, 4-0.
Central Coast Leagues is proud to announce a significant internal redevelopment of the club, which will commence in the next couple of months and will take close to 12 months to complete. Included in the development is new reception areas,
And welcome back to Plume Park for the second period of 25 minutes. The Hutch 11 leading the Central Coast Mariners 4-0 here. And I'll tell you what, the players are going to be sucking in the big one. It wasn't a long break, Michael Komet.
No, it wasn't a long break at all. It was supposed to be a five-minute break, but they're straight back on into the game.
And so we'll cross down to Luke Byrne, who's down the touchline.
Nick Merger joins us, former Central Coast Mariners striker. What a night it is here at Plume Park to celebrate a legend of the Central Coast Mariners in Australian football.
Yeah, good to be back, and good on Hutch for picking it out that long, and yeah, all the best to him for everything after, I suppose.
What does he mean to the Central Coast Mariners in your time at the club?
What does it mean?
What does he mean?
Oh, look, 10 years is a milestone with any player at any club, and Hutch to be here from the very start. It just shows you, like everything that he's put in, and then in the end, it's rewarding for him.
You're back in Perth now. What are you doing these days?
Living the retired life, mate. Not doing much at the moment.
A little bit of fishing?
A little bit of everything, yeah. Full driving, fishing, just enjoying myself and all the time I've lost out here.
Are you hoping to get on the score sheet here tonight?
Oh, mate, look, that doesn't bother me. It's just more about seeing the guys and catching up and having a laugh, I suppose. But, yeah, it's a definite eye-opener to how I feel out there to how I used to be.
Nick, thanks for joining us here.
No worries, buddy.
Nick Merger down there with Luke Burns.
It's always good for an interview, isn't he, Nick Merger?
Tom Slater in a rare touch of the football in the yellow jersey in the first team.
Saw some FFA Cup action, though.
Certainly did. Matt Sim. Slater. Still Slater. Feet now of Caceres. Fitzgerald wide of him, dispossessed though.
Roston Griffiths there.
Griffiths away now, Roston variety. Feeds to Abini, chasing down Poscolero. Abini. One more time. Oh, sniper in the field, sir. The ball's away. That was their chance there, the Hutch 11 to make it 5 and almost shut the gate, you'd have to say.
They had the numbers. Matt Crowell was ghosting at the far post there. He's another blast from the past, Matt Crowell, now captain of Central Coast Mariners Academy. So he'll be playing tomorrow against Beauchamp and Heffernan.
Chris Doig on the field. Might be feeling the effects of some jet lag. Landed at 5 a.m. this morning.
Wow.
From the UK, Sasha Petrosi's come from the field. He's been hooked. Obviously, Laurie McKinnis sent enough.
Too threatening, I think, Sasha. And shoot at will.
Slater.
Just to let you know, there's been a goalkeeper change for the Mariners. It is Zach Anderson in goals.
That's who it was. We were trying to work out who it was, Luke. Thanks for the update.
Now it's going to be Caceres going for a run up against Hutchison. Right-hand side will be Ferreira. He's trying to stand up one. Tomasevic there. Misguided header, shot towards goal. Deflection will be a corner. Plenty of time over the football there. And deflected away.
Tony Vidmar there trying to psych his attacker out. He's got very intense eyes at times, Tony Vidmar. I'm sure he utilised that as he jumped in front of Trefiro.
Trefiro plays it out of the corner. Sim. Sim and Trefiro again. Breaking now. Sajoski. Empty net because I think you'll find that Zach Anderson may have forgotten that he was playing goalkeeper. And that means it's Mile Sajoski.
Is that it for the night? You just scored your goal and get off?
No, mate. That's the floodgates have opened now. I'm going to get a few more.
Well done.
Sajoski there with...
Where was Zach Anderson, though? That's the question. You see him in the background sprinting through.
I think that you'll find that Bernie Abini was probably in offside position. There was a defender there. There was not the second one. That's how far that Zach Anderson was up the field in the goalkeeper's jersey. Liam Reddy obviously needing a well-earned break. Conceding 4 or 5. He wanted to find a hole to bury himself in. Top of the penalty area now. It's going to be Storm Rue. Fitzgerald. Nick Fitzgerald, what can he do? He can find Caceres. He's turning on all the tricks. Sim now. Sim, two defenders coming across, dispossessing. Diving to the corner here, saved just on the goal line there. And it'll be taken away now.
Chris Doig.
Played out by Chris Doig off the left. Still playing competitive football, Chris Doig.
It's great ball, Chris Doig.
Into the centre now.
He'd probably be the fittest guy out here, actually.
He brought down by Roston Griffiths. Roston Griffiths thought about going himself. Lays it off here. Looks to be Kwasnik. And it's going to be played out by the Mariners. Luke Byrne down the touchline.
Liam Reddy joins me here on John Hutchinson's special night. A great club man here for the Central Coast Mariners.
Yeah, definitely. It's fantastic the amount of people that turned up to show their acknowledgement for what he's done for the club for the last 10 years. So it's a great turnout, and looks like everyone's having a bit of fun.
You've played against him quite a few times in the A-League. What's it like to play against him here tonight for the Mariners?
Yeah, I mean, it's all a bit of fun now, so no 3 points on the line, but yeah, it's good. I mean, it's a great occasion that everyone's come in from all over the country and even from the UK, so it just shows what a great player he was for the club, that all these players have come tonight, and the fan turnout's fantastic. I think at least 2,000 here, 3,000, so it's a great turnout.
You made a substitution after the first period. Zach Anderson is in goal. How do you rate his goalkeeping skills?
Well, he actually hasn't had to make a save yet, so I'll hold my judgment on that.
But he got caught out of position a little bit?
Yeah, well, to be fair, the goalkeeper's getting caught out today. Me and Vukra have been going up and back, but hopefully we can try to find the back of the net here soon.
You got Matty Simon's number on. Are you looking to get on and go forward?
Yeah, they've given me Matty Simon's number, obviously, because I'm just going to go on and kick people. So they said, got to wear Matty Simon's number to do that.
Liam Reddy, thanks for joining us.
No problems.
Very funny there from Liam Reddy. Got Matt Simon's number on, so he's going to go out and kick people. Oh, Bernie's away now.
Oh, straight into the arms there of Zach Anderson. Bernie Abeni thinks that maybe five's enough. 32 minutes gone of, well, I should say 7 minutes of the second period gone.
Slightly different maths, isn't it, Trent? 23, 25 minute thirds tonight.
It's like watching an ice hockey match. Caceres goes long range into the arms there of Danny Vukovic. And it will be played away now by Mariners with Trofiro. Ball into the penalty area. Oh, left there by Montgomery. Shot towards goal. And it's in. The Mariners score and the crowd goes up. And Danny Vukovic appeals for offside. Wasn't forthcoming. And it will be the opening of the scoring there for the Central Coast Mariners 11. Luke Byrne running out there to get the interview.
Yeah, you know, very important this goal. So hopefully we can still go get the game.
Who did you dedicate this goal to?
This goal is dedicated to my mom.
Well, thank you, Fabio.
Fabio Ferreira there. Opening the scoring for the Central Coast Mariners FC. 5-1 the score. It's Mariners earned the ball back through Tom Slater from the Hutch 11 kickoff. It's going to be Tom Ponyalak looking to get back on the field. Just down there, Luke Byrne. Now the ball on the right-hand side, Ferreira. Ferreira again. In towards Slater. Into the penalty area. Thinking about going down there, Fitzgerald. That's going to be away now for the Hutch 11. Stojoski. Cross on the left-hand side. Heffernan back on the field. Fed out. Roston Griffiths being held up towards the far post. Out there again. Petroski bends it in, strikes the upright. Anderson found all wanting at sea. Roston Griffiths makes no mistake, though. Hits the back of the net. And there we go. The Hutch 11.
Those headphones.
And look out, we've got Danny Vukovic wants to go up and...
How are we, fellas?
Well, thank you, Danny Vukovic.
Go see Roston and see what he thought about his goal. Great strike. What did you think?
I've not seen a better goal like that all season. I think you'll agree.
I think that was goal of the game, for sure.
So far, mate. Just keep feeding me.
All right, we'll do.
There was Danny Vukovic interviewing Roston Griffiths for the goal that makes a Hutch 11-6, the Central Coast Mariners 1.
For his effort, Roston Griffiths, he's getting subbed. Andre Glumprecht to come on. Sasha Petroski again hitting the post. He scored one. Looking very threatening tonight. Sasha Petroski, he's harnessing all that energy going back to that famous semi-final win against Newcastle where the Mariners won 3-2 and he scored the winner. 3-2 in aggregate, actually. It was 3-0 that night.
Certainly was. Now, a run here by Sim strikes the back of the heels. Andrew Clark gets in there for the boys in the blue shirts there, the Hutch 11. Takes the ball away down the with Simon now. Delivers the ball all the way across the face of the penalty box. Being held up. Pushed on there by Stojoski. Away now for the Mariners. Through Rue. Stojoski in late and behind. Gumprick offering no resistance. Still with Rue. Out towards Slater now. Sim. Top of the penalty area with Fitzgerald. Once again, Ferreira. Fitzgerald. It's all broken down, though, for the Mariners. That'll allow the Hutch 11 to resume their dominance. Andrew Clark. Out towards Simon. Stojoski. Matt Simon, can you deliver a pinpoint cross? Diving header off the line. Mariners clear. Sim plays back gently. And it'll come out via Sarah. She's up and down the park at the moment. Left-hand side. Oh, we see Liam Reddy.
And he's missed. Did he miss? Or he scored from there?
No, he threw the ball over the top of the crossbar. And I guess if it's Gaelic football, he's trying to pants the referee on the way through as well.
Are they going to allow this? Controversy if they do. Liam Reddy. No, I don't think that was allowed.
And it's going to be taken away by the Hutch 11. I think you might find a longer break between these two periods, the second and third period, to allow some players to catch their breaths here this evening. Bit of comedy happening out there on the field. See Anderson taking the ball away.
Just lightening things up, isn't he? Liam Reddy, fantastic effort there by him. Just a bit of fun in this whole match, as we thought it would be. And he's been the comedy factor tonight, hasn't he, Liam Reddy?
He's certainly trying to add his own special mark to the match, celebrating John Hutchison's career at the Central Coast Mariners.
Dean Heffernan.
Ooh, looking for something there. And he's going to get it too, Dean Heffernan. He asked the question of the referee and he got the response he was looking for. And clearly, we haven't seen so much of Michael Beauchamp in the match so far. Clearly saving himself for tomorrow afternoon's matchup here against the Mariners Academy.
Yeah, I don't think it's in Dean Heffernan's DNA to do the same. He's been running so hard out there. He chased Storm Rue down for a ball. He's made the run down the left. Danny Vukovic is going to step up and take this free kick.
Now,
against Zach Anderson, I think he'd fancy himself, wouldn't he?
Look at the players' breaths. You don't often see that Mariners matches where you see the breath of the players, where it's that cold, and something different here. It's certainly starting to chill down now here at Plume Park.
Just grateful there's no fog out there like it normally is at this time of night during winter.
So Vukovic over the ball. It's going to be left, left, left. Three run over the ball, and now Vukovic will come up and address the ball. His right boot doesn't miss the football, but it's well wide of the goal. Strikes it well there. The custodian here for the Hutch 11.
He put plenty on it, didn't he, Trent? But just kept sailing and sailing. Free kick expert, he's not. But I remember in his Mariners days, Danny Vukovic, he used to always fancy himself. as a striker, and he's often there shooting against players, especially Nigel Bugard, who often put the gloves on.
Slater now up against Clark. Slater inside Clark, inside two, and one of them, and Slater, oh, he puts one away.
It's like that was a deflection there off Chris Doig as it went through. Great run by Tommy Slater. Probably too late to be playing for contracts, but it was an excellent run.
Here's Tom Slater down with Luke Byrne.
Great goal, Tommy. What did you say?
Own goal.
Own goal there. Own goal there.
He's not claiming it. He's going to go own goal there, Tom Slater.
Very honest.
Watching on a replay, Slater down the left-hand side. Clark came across. It did Clark inside him. Beat another. I think it was Bershop, and it must have just taken a deflection there off Chris Doig and in past the goalkeeper there in Vukovic.
Probably quickest run of the night from anyone, Tommy Slater, that came through, and I think that surprised a few players.
New goalkeeper for the Central Coast Mariners, 11-year-old boy.
11-year-old boy. Oh, I see. Anderson.
Oh, it's a header. It's a goal.
11-year-old boy has been beaten. His first touch is to pull the ball on the back of the net. And that will make it 6-3. Dean Heffernan coming across.
It was Dean Heffernan with the header. And Zach Anderson just plucked the young boy out of the crowd, gave him the gloves.
Here's Dean Heffernan.
Heff, that would have been one of your best goals.
Eyes closed. Just trying to protect the face at all costs. Quite.
He's a good goalkeeper, isn't he?
Take the money maker.
It was Dean Heffernan ensuring that the face is protected and the shirt was tailored.
Absolutely. He was, him and Pej Boic were known for tailoring their shirts for the Mariners, but he, as he said, he wanted to protect his face there, make sure he got a nice clean header on the ball, Dean Heffernan.
I think a few of these blue shirts will be sucking in now with 8 minutes until the next break. 7-2. Moment. Benches are quite full here at the home of Central Coast Football, Plume Park. And Mohamed, what a crowd out here for a testimonial match. I mean, 2,500. It may even beaten some of those crowds for the Asian Champions League.
Oh, without a doubt, would have been some Asian Champions League game. And look, I know a lot of the players, a lot of the fans out there have been starved for football the last 4 weeks. Great opportunity to come out and connect again with their beloved club, the Central Coast Mariners. Fantastic for the club to put on such a great night and really engage with the community. They've done a fantastic job, I think, in the last 2 months or so, getting back out there, particularly the last 4 weeks, getting back out in the community and re-engaging with some of the fans out there.
The Mariners are away with the ball now. Swith Sim. And now it's going to be back again, spinning around. A little Facebook comment that's come in. It's John Hutchison. Very much that's the kind of guy he is. He just loves to say hello in the streets, and there's no, I guess, ego to him in a metaphorical sense. Plenty of physical ego we've heard about here this evening. His big bum, but certainly none of that in the...
No, absolutely right. No ego about John Hutchison. And now we see the young boy. What a night he'd be having. That'll be... Remember that forever. He got such a big cheer there.
In front of one of the biggest crowds seen at Plume Park in some time. So it's Pereira now. Back out again. Back out again on the right-hand side. Free kick here now. Pereira is high-fiving there. Heff just getting used to the pitch here, and as we heard him say, he'll be out here tomorrow afternoon, 3 p.m., against the Mariners Academy for the Bankstown Lions. Apex of the penalty area. Plenty of shirts being drawn back. towards the far post. Vukovic easily to cover his post and takes the ball in his full. And I dare say he will be able to have a run out in the field during the final period of this match, the final third, with 7-2 the score at the moment. The Hutch 11 will feel pretty comfortable in that. Simon. Clark in the centre. What can Simon do? Delivers it back towards Kwosnik. Kwosnik again, trying to turn around. Can't do so. Simon. Inside Slater. Still Simon again. Back now towards Beauchamp. Out there in the familiar number four jersey. Ball on the left-hand side. Hutch 11 showing their dominance so far. I haven't seen too much of Matt Osman. One of the players is lining up. Oh, Anderson flapping at the ball. Wasn't able to make contact there. Kwosnik was bearing in on the 23 jersey. Going to be cleared up here for Kwosnik again. Teed up now for Clark. Right-hand side. It's Gumprek.
It's Razzle Dazzle show.
And it's a long range off the upright. Driving shot put in there. And it'll be away now. Looks to be Bingham.
Guys, I've got Laurie McKinnon down here, the manager of Hutch's 11. Laurie, must have been some great training sessions because they're performing beautifully here tonight.
Yeah, I think it was all the beers before the game. It's definitely helped, but I'm a bit disappointed we've conceded two goals. I'd like to clean sheet, but nah, 7-2, and it's just good fun out there. The boys are having fun, and it's just great to see so many old faces back, and I think that's why the crowd's enjoying it so much.
And tactically, you've had to make a lot of substitutions here this evening. What is this reason?
It's the lack of oxygen in the lungs. So, but now it's not about boys lasting the full game and pulling a hamstring. It's about having fun for Hutch, respect for Hutch, and respect for the fans in the Central Coast as well. It's just changing and a little bit of fun.
And out there this evening, we're seeing some Mariners legends, including Matty Simon for the last time. He's been a stalwart of this football club.
Yeah, like the top all-time scorer, and it's sad to see him leave. You know, now I wish, I'm sure he'll get another A-League club because he'll... And what's going to happen, he's going to come back to Central Coast Stadium one day and haunt the team because they're nobody worse. All opposition defenders hate playing against Matt Simon.
What's going to be your team talk for the third period?
Just make sure you take plenty of oxygen because they'll be needing it by then, and make sure you've got a masseur set up for a rub after the game.
Adam Kwosnik just scores. I better go and have a chat.
Matt Simon playing deliverer once again from out wide. And Adam Kwosnik, of course, a coaching role in the local Premier League alongside his good friend Brad Porter, puts one there past Zach Anderson. Here he is with Luke Byrne.
Adam Kwosnik, what's better, scoring a goal here this evening or being named in the team of the decade?
Oh, named in the team of the decade, that's for sure. But Simo knew it was coming. Just a matter of time before I scored Tricky. Just a matter of time. I'm done now.
Getting a brace?
Maybe a Hattie.
Hattie there for Adam Kwosnik.
Adam Kwosnik out there netting one here tonight. Two more to go for him. There's only about 2 and a bit minutes left in this second of three periods. 3 25-minute periods being played here tonight.
Something tricky here, we see. Anthony Caceres putting it through and they're away. But flag. It looks like it's offside.
Flags up. And
John Hutchison, of course, hails Trent from the town of Morwell in Victoria, and I'm led to believe that they're back at the Morwell Falcons clubhouse. There's a group of people over there watching the stream at the moment, so a big shout out if you're out there in Morwell watching the game.
Very much so. Remembering the times of John Hutchison, I think he was at Eastern Pride at one stage in the old National League. Plenty of players that have hailed out of the Morwell area. You see Anderson saving the Mariners this time. 8-2 they trail though.
Zach Anderson with his finger to the crowd. He's finally happy that he's saved the ball. Couldn't stem the goals coming through Zach Anderson, even after he placed Liam Reddy.
Ball on the right-hand side, into the penalty, fed through towards Sim. Now Sim, what can he do? He holds the ball up. Pass him again. Coming in around behind him. One more. Top of penalty area. Turn, shot, snapshot, wide. In the end. Let's just talk quickly about John Hutchison and his career for a 35-year-old. So we all know about the 228 competitive games for the Mariners. But there are so many more that we'll talk about after the break as we hear that is the end of the second period. It's the Central Coast Mariners 11-8. Sorry, Hutch 11-8 leading the Central Coast Mariners 2.
Central Coast Leagues is proud to announce a significant internal redevelopment of the club, which will commence in the next couple of months and will take close to 12 months to complete. Included in the development is new reception areas, our fresco gaming and updated dining facilities throughout the ground floor of the club. These changes will be a great refresh of the facilities and enable members to sit in comfort and enjoy a drink or dine with friends. Plans of the new facilities will be on display in the club in the near future.
Welcome back to Plume Park for the final third here between the Hutch 11 and the Central Coast Mariners 11. And there are a lot of players out in the field now for this final third period.
I think it's been a change in formation, Trent. 17 players out there. Looks like a 10-4-3 formation. All 17 players, including two Mariners goalkeepers in there. And Danny Vukovic has put the blue shirt on. He's going to play striker as well. Is that Adam Kwasnik, as you see there, just forcing a save. He's a new keeper as well.
So we're going to see Luke Byrne on the touchline.
Yeah, substitution here. Jake's coming on, pushed out by Mile Sajossi, so it's going to be a fantastic occasion.
Coming out for the kick of the football. Real mainstay of the Central Coast Mariners Club. And being pushed out there by Mile Sajossi, John Hutchison. Taking control and keeps a breather going now for the team in blue. Vukovic now over the football and Jake making a run up to the penalty area. diving tackle missed. Two diving tackle missed. One from Montgomery. A goalkeeper missed. Jake with the ball at his feet. Two goalkeepers being beaten here. And Jake will kick the ball straight into the goal. And he'll pick up another goal for the Hutch 11. Rack them up for 9.
Just beat all the challenges before him. Well done.
Great goal, John Hutchinson, wasn't it?
That's a great goal. What a finish as well. It's one of the best finishes tonight. The main man, Jake, he's the main man.
Straight down the centre there, Jake. An assist perhaps to John Hutchinson and Miley Sajoski. But a great experience to be out there. And to beat nearly 15 players out there as well. It looks to be that many yellow shirts out there at the moment.
I think that's the quickest the players moved all night, I think. Jake, with the pace of this game. Oh, well done. Beating two keepers, no mean feat.
Just let you know, Mariners have made another goalkeeping change. Eddie Bosnar is joined by Adam Pearce.
We were just talking before the break, Malcolm, about the number of appearances of John Hutchinson. He's 228 with the Mariners. Then there's 89 with the Eastern Pride, 77 with Northern Spirit, 25 with Manly United during the hiatus of the National League, and then also 14 with Chengdu Blades.
Yeah, it's quite incredible, isn't it? It's a career that spans over, 20 years there, almost.
And don't forget, 11 national caps for Malta.
Yes, as well. No goals, unfortunately, there. But
playing in Euro qualifiers.
Yeah, that would have been... very proud for John Hutchinson of Maltese heritage with his grandmother as well. But, yeah, a career that spans 20 years there. It's quite incredible.
So, Rue here for the Mariners. Oh, he's turned the ball straight over towards Petroski. Now it's...
cast of thousands out there. Let's see another... Facebook pop up through. It's not one moment for me. It's his passion and fire each and every game that is inspirational. Even when the team is rock bottom, he still inspires them on your champ. Well done, Vinny Mathers.
Oh, surely he's handling the ball. Sir, the referee allowing play to continue.
This game's degenerated, hasn't it?
Must have missed that one. I think there might be a few players where the sweat and the pre-match alcohol is starting to take over.
Absolutely. I think there'll be a few drinks after the game as well, maybe, with these players. They'd all be celebrating the wonderful career of John Hutchinson.
Some of the players may not be having as too many drinks with the having to play here tomorrow.
No, that's right. Dean Heffernan, Michael Bouchot, Matty Crow, Danny Vukovic is away here.
Not to mention the add to the ones of last night at the Mariners Medal Award.
Yes, that was a
very positive night.
Absolutely.
For the club.
Anthony Caceres getting the Mariners medal for player of the season. Congratulations for him.
Petroski shoots wide.
Boys, I've got Matt Simon down here. Matt Simon, a great night to celebrate one of the Mariners' finest.
Yeah, look, it's a great turnout for Hutch, and it's good to see all some old faces back and being back together. It's been a good enjoyable night.
You joined the Mariners very early on in the existence of the club. You've seen some great players come through. It's great to see them all here tonight.
Yeah, it's exactly right. As you say, there's been some amazing players play for this team, and for the majority of them to come back tonight, through some of the successful times, it's really good for Hutch, and, it's good to see everyone back having a laugh.
What about yourself, Matty? What are you looking forward to in the next chapter of your footballing career?
Yeah, look, I'll be playing somewhere. I'm not too sure where that is at the moment, but, I've got a bit of time off at the moment to think about things and hopefully can make a decision soon.
All the best, Matty. Go well.
Cheers, thanks.
Matt Simon down there with Luke Byrne. A beanie over the ball now for the Hutch 11. Ponyalak. Vukovic. Plays it back for Hutchison. Hasn't got on the score sheet yet, the skipper.
No, he hasn't been as influential.
Vukovic off the head. Heads down. Goal, Danny Vukovic. That's a quality header in anyone's language. Straight down to the ground. Where to beat the goalkeeper. Two of them, in fact. Vukovic gets the goal into the centre. I think that's all he wanted out from this evening. And Danny Vukovic will go from interviewer to interviewee.
Danny, great goal here this evening. Which is better, the goal that you scored in the A-League or this one here tonight?
This one, I think, as soon as that came off my eye. Didn't actually hit me in the head, so
I think it's this one, mate.
So you weren't trying to protect the face at all? It looks pretty good here this evening.
No, I can't hit the ball probably, mate. I honestly wanted to go off my head and it hit my eye, so at least it went in.
Good goal.
Danny Vukovic down there getting a run on the field.
Had good hang time, didn't he, Danny, as you expect from a goalkeeper? And I think he's just flattering himself, saying that hit him off the eye.
Now, I think Liam Reddy has informed the Mariners about the old Parramatta wall of 1982 and is going to play that. I'm pretty sure his dad may have been in the club when they pulled it off as they make their way down the field now in the turtle, some have described it as. And the Mariners make that, and it's popped out the back, and it's gone wide in the end there by Brent Griffiths, who tried to deliver it off the left boot and curl it around the goalkeeper, and it didn't quite make it.
He's the one who left the wall there, Brent Griffiths, and put himself in great position, but just couldn't get a goal there.
Right-hand side to Vukovic again. He'll want to
look at him go.
He'll want a brace here, Vukovic. I couldn't even tell you who's in goals at the moment. It's going to be now with a beanie.
Zach Anderson, new goalkeeper.
And Avini pots it. What he would wish to have that have occurred in the grand final last week against the Melbourne Victory wasn't to be for Bernie Avini, but he's potted one here for the Hutch 11, man that he played for quite some time. Bernie Avini.
Nice goal, Bernie. First one for Hutch's team.
Yeah, obviously it's a very, very important goal. I can't say much else apart from that.
Team of the decade last night, you must be proud.
Yeah, very proud. It's a huge honour to make the team of the decade. I had a great couple of years here, so it's a very great honour.
Well done, Bernie.
Bernie Abini, of course, 2010 to 2013 and 2014 here at the Mariners. 96 appearances for the Central Coast Mariners, Bernie Abini, before moving on to Sydney FC. Yeah, via China, of course.
Yeah, of course. A fine player, Bernie Abini. Next chapter of his life. Got to play an A-League grand final last week. It didn't go well for him, but third A-League grand final now, and the forgotten grand final against Brisbane, he was certainly came on as substitute and nearly won the game for the Mariners.
Petroski here now over the ball. Petroski shoots. He'll go over the top. There, nothing happening there for Petroski. 10-2. Hutch 11.
Zach Anderson joins me here, pitch side. Zach, a great night for football here on the Central Coast to celebrate John Hutchinson.
Yeah, it's an amazing night. It's just amazing to see all these ex-teammates come from a long way, some from the UK to be here tonight. And the turnout from the fans and these supporters is massive as well. So it's a fantastic evening.
Goal-keeping change during the first period. You went into goal. Liam Reddy was highly critical. How did you think you went?
Yeah, no, fair assessment from Rocky. I wasn't great. I was pretty poor, but had a lot of fun. The ball boy came in and had a bit of a go as well. So, no, it was a lot of fun, but I'll leave the glove work to Rocky.
Where are you off to next in your footballing career?
I'm not sure yet, mate. I'm going back to Brisbane for a little bit of a vacation, but there's a goal. There's a goal from Liam Reddy. He's popped up in front of the mascots there, so that makes it 11-2. But, yeah, not sure, mate. I'm hoping to go overseas in the next couple of weeks.
Go well, Zach.
Thanks a lot, mate.
The goal potted past the sauce bottles there. 11-3, the score now here at Plume Park. We've got a comment here from Liam Reddy, who's down there with Luke Byrne.
First goal, Liam Reddy in Mariners colours, a fantastic strike.
Yeah, no, I was really just aiming for cause.
So it was a bad strike?
Yeah, no, it was a good strike, but I was just going for cause, but he ducked out of the way. Good brave goalkeeper, isn't he?
Liam Reddy.
It was Liam Reddy. Letting players know exactly how hard goalkeeping actually is. You see a sauce bottle and a captain out there. Captain gets a touch. A sauce bottle makes a break. And there's an admiral out there as well.
There's certainly good mascots rather than footballers struggling to control that. And the sauce bottle. Oh, he's been sabotaged by Fabio Ferreira.
He's learnt what you do at Disneyland. The lack of peripheral vision there for the sponsor's sauce bottle.
The Master Foods sauce bottle there, barbecue sauce getting through. Now the Admiral gets hit in the head. Plenty of shenanigans happening.
Still some 15 minutes remaining in this match.
We thought the game started at a pedestrian pace. I think it's gone down to a walk now. 14 goals, though. Thoroughly entertaining.
Oh, my God. Look at him.
Yes, the crowd has seen plenty of action, plenty of theatrics, and some good comedy as well here this evening.
Indeed.
Right-hand side now. For the Mariners. Oh, header coming through, and it's a great goal coming through. I think you'll find
Liam Reddy popping up again. Great header, Liam Reddy.
Climbing high.
Liam Reddy, two goals here this evening. A fantastic performance.
Yeah, I'm looking for one more, and I get the trophy off Boz and Fabio and Juki and whoever have ever scored three goals this year.
Not many others have scored three goals.
Oh, that's fine. After one more, and I'll get the golden boot.
Well done.
Yes, he will. Three goals will earn you a golden boot at the Central Coast Mariners this season. And so Liam Reddy wants to share that prize awarded last night.
Well, Daniel McBreen was the first to score a hat-trick for the Mariners.
In one game, but three goals got you over a season, got you the golden boot this season. Oh, late shocking challenge. Brent Griffiths.
On the sauce bottle.
He's going to get sent off. He's off. He's off.
He's gone.
Brent Griffiths clapping the crowd. Oh, that's horrendous.
Brent Griffiths.
Last ever challenge in Mariners colours. He's known for his red cards too, isn't he, Brent Griffiths?
Beat Youth League or beat the first team.
The ACL.
We're watching a replay now. Oh, that is shocking for a guy who's wearing spandex in a suit coming from behind.
I think the sauce bottle will be applying the ice after the game. Looks like we've got an interview with Brent Griffiths as well.
Yep.
Brent Griffiths down here, pitch side. Brent, that was a pretty ordinary tackle.
Yeah, it's probably one of my least worst tackles, actually. I think I've done a few more worse than that.
And how many red cards is that for the season?
For the season, I think, well, I don't know, my entire three-year career at the Mariners, must be at least three or four reds, to be honest.
And obviously, post-Mariners, what are you looking to do next in your footballing career?
Oh, I'll be heading back to Perth for a little bit of a holiday, and then I've got a few irons in the fire, so maybe anything's on the cards right now, Asia and South Africa, America, Europe, we'll just see what happens, even the A-League, so open book.
It's been a good night here to send John Hutchison off.
Yeah, definitely. You know, Hutch is a legend of the game and something special for all the players out there, to be fair, and the Mariners, and we'll always remember him for being a great person and a great player.
Good luck with the next chapter of your career.
Thanks, guys.
Sim delivers the cross. Liam Reddy looking for three. Turns once, turns twice, and they give him three, and that is the first hat-trick of the match. Luke Byrne puts a sprint on to go and interview him. He can ask him exactly how he's going to share the golden boot prize now with his Mariners teammates.
Oh, Liam Reddy, superb work. Kinking, diving, left to right, left to right. Then
congratulations, Liam Reddy, golden boot this season for the Central Coast Mariners.
Club's going to have to make a new trophy now.
You must be really stoked to be the golden boot winner.
I am. I'm over the moon to share it with 12 other players.
Very good, Liam Reddy.
He's been the highlight tonight for sure, Liam Reddy.
Very, very good. So we're going to have the trio kickoff here of a sauce bottle, an admiral, and a captain.
Sauce bottle's still going. Can't believe he's still walking that sauce bottle. That Brent Griffiths challenge. But looks like one of the master foods will get a goal here.
Oh,
that's straight at the keeper.
Straight into the goalkeeper doing plenty of work. Oh! Gone down.
Sabotaged himself.
He's looking for the penalty as the little bit of fog starts to roll in here at Plume Park. Get onto the field.
I think there's been a bit of offside happening there as well.
Well, I'm just trying to work out if the officials know which team they're playing for.
He can't see. The Admiral just can't see.
He just thinks he knows someone's there.
Here we go.
Sauce bottle can snap shoot.
Oh, through the legs.
Hit the upright.
Oh, he's hit the post.
That's been taken away, and it should be put back up the end of the other end of the field now. I'm not sure if Stephen Lucas has had an easier appointment in his time at the moment in the A-League and the National Premier League, in New South Wales National Premier League competition.
I'm sure he's not drawing A-League wages for this match, though. So I think it's all par for course.
Left-hand side now. Steaming run here put on by Sim, looking for the ball. Bouchamp, though, intercepts.
We should be a specialist at this time of the game, shouldn't he, Matt Sim? A-League FFA Cup 4 goals coming on as a substitute.
Abini, Dajoski, Abini, Petros, Hutchison.
Razzle Dazzle.
I reckon Hutchison and Abini. Hutchison, is he looking for one here for tonight? Simon. Simon with the ball. Flag goes up, I think, on there against Matt Simon. I think he's a bit surprised.
Andrew Clark was waiting in the middle.
Simon hasn't scored, has he?
No, he hasn't scored. I think he's got about 8 assists, though.
He's played provider all night, Matt Simon. Crowd is just a solid crowd out here. I'm just having a look again. No one's leaving either. I mean, it's not here. You're not here for the actual scoreline, 11-5.
No.
Surprising scoreline.
Nudging on 3,000 here, the crowd.
You're here for
it looks like there's a bit of a scuffle.
Well, I think the mall has collapsed on Hutchison.
Who's just for one final time.
Yeah, he's taking the ball and wants to take it quickly, go up the field. He's been pulled back.
John Hutchison special, drawing a foul there. It's Danny Vukovic looks like he's away, but... Oh, as he puts a shot on goal. What was he thinking, Danny Vukovic?
Danny Vukovic needs to go and talk to Liam Reddy about how to score goals.
Absolutely. Could the Mariners have a solution to their goal-scoring woes in Liam Reddy?
Well, 3-1 match, as you said, that's earned your golden boot this season. It is with Liam Reddy now. Oh, he's played in the path here of Matt Simon. Matt Simon goes down the penalty area under a challenge from Liam Reddy. And that will be a penalty. And will that be the gift to John Hutchison with some 7 minutes remaining? Or is Matt Simon going to step up and take the penalty?
No, it looks like it's John Hutchison. Rightly so. Matty Simon, one of his best mates there, did the right thing, try and draw him a foul, and he did it. And this great crowd of nearly 3,000 applauding John Hutchison. He's taken it a few yards forward.
Did he need any help, John Hutchison?
Adam Pearce won't want to save this.
And there we are. John Hutchison scores from... Well, there's no penalty spot marked, but where he felt the penalty spot was, and all the blue shirts gathered around him, that's 12-5 here now at Plume Park. The Hutch 11 giving it to the Central Coast Mariners 11. And here is John Hutchison down there with Luke Byrne.
Nice way to cap off the night, John.
Yeah, it's been good. It's been enjoyable for the boys, but I'm done. I'm going off.
So, penalty taking hasn't been your forte. Great finish.
Yeah, look, a bit closer than normal, but it was a good finish, so I'm happy with that.
Who have you been impressed with your team this evening?
None of them are getting a contract. They all asked for it, but I've got no money left, so they can't get one.
John Hutchison, assistant manager to the Central Coast Mariners now. He's going to get substituted shortly. No, there's probably no one left on the benches because everyone's on the field.
It looks like 17 on 20 there, almost.
Still very
compact and compressed, isn't it? With those amount of players out there.
Coming up to the final 5 minutes of the allotted 75. Three periods played here tonight. Quick changes. It's put into the penalty area, chested down now. Taken away now by Simon.
Not much left in this match. Good 5 minutes left, and for the celebratory night, this fantastic crowd that's come out here, Central Coast Mariners supporters. It's been fantastic.
We see Pearce up towards halfway. Liam Reddy. Oh, it looks like there's a substitution happening. Cross down to Luke Byrne, who's down the touchline.
Yeah, substitution being made by Hutch's 11. I think it is going to be for the captain, the number 7, John Hutchison.
The guard of honour being formed here by both teams and giving John Hutchison a clap off the field. John Hutchison, 10 years with the one club in the A-League. An A-League record coming off the field for the final time. Bracing his former coach and Laurie McKinna. First kick steward there in Joe Spiteri. across to Nigel Bugard.
And that's full time, gentlemen.
And they're calling it short. That is full time here at Plume Park. It is the Hutch 11-12, the Central Coast Mariners 11-5, in front of an impressive crowd here at Plume Park. Over 3,000 coming to farewell John Hutchison, and John Hutchison will now make his way with the rest of his teammates and his team around the field to farewell the Mariners faithful. So we'll go down to Luke Byrne shortly. He'll grab us some full-time interviews. He's got free reign tonight. He's the host broadcaster. He can do what he wants. And Luke Byrne's down there with Mariners medal winner, Caceres.
Anthony Caceres, a spectacular night of football here this evening. John Hutchison got the send-off he deserved.
Yeah, he definitely did. He's given his all for this club. He's an example for us all to look up to. And, you know, he's a true leader. So we're looking to have him around in the coaching staff for the next year. And I think with him and Tony in charge, We'll have a great season. So, you know, Hutch deserves everything he gets from the fans, from the boys. And, you know, I wish you could give him more, but, you know, a fitting end to a great career.
Now, on a personal note, congratulations on the Mariners medal last night. Well deserved. You must be stoked with your first real full season of A-League football that you're able to pick up such an honour.
Oh, yeah, definitely. You know, I'm very happy. Words can't describe how humbled I am by it all. And, you know, obviously I have my teammates to thank for everything and the club for giving me the opportunity to play. So, you know, feeling very happy at the moment, and, you know, a great night like this tops it off.
Well done.
Thank you very much.
There was Anthony Caceres down there with Luke Byrne.
Just got Central Coast Mariners new skipper Nick Montgomery. Congratulations on the honour of becoming the Mariners new skipper.
Yeah, thank you. It's a great honour. Obviously, taking over from Hutch, you've seen the respect the guys earned over his 10 years at the Mariners. And I think tonight was, you know, it was a good bit of fun. You know, the fans want to see the old boys in action. I think a few of them were looking a bit rusty towards the end, but obviously, a nice bit of fun. And, you know, we look forward to next season now.
It's not very often that you get to have an event like this. 10 years at the club is a very long time.
Oh, yeah, it's very rare nowadays. So, like I said, it's just special. He's a special guy, and it's, I think, tonight showing the support and the fans really showing their appreciation for what he's done, not just for the Mariners, for the Central Coast.
How's he going to fit into the assistant coaching role next season?
Yeah, well, he's already started, so he's doing really well, and without doubt, you know, I'm sure in the next couple of years he'll definitely be top coaches in the A-League.
Good luck next season, Nick Montgomery.
Thank you.
Luke Byrne's got some run ahead of him now to get across to the victory lap, which is occurring now for John Hutchison, who's leading it, and the applause behind him. Very few of the crowd have left so far, mocked that as well.
No, they should, as the players do a walk around. Some of the ex-legends and the current squad all together. And this fantastic celebration tonight of a man who's had a wonderful career. Wonderful career with the Central Coast Mariners, a decade of football. Next chapter in his life, he's still there.
I'm joined here by Chris Doig, who made the longest trip here to John Hutchinson's testimonial. An exciting achievement by John to play 10 years here at one club.
Oh, fantastic. By anybody to stay that long at one club is a great achievement, and, you know, he deserves all this. He is Mr. Mariners, really, you know, and it's a massive achievement to be at the one club, and I think everyone's shown what he means to them, you know.
Excited to be back in Oz after a long time back in Scotland again?
Yeah, I've really enjoyed it. I've always wanted to come back. I said I would. The last few summers I've had a few things that have stopped me coming, but first opportunity I could get, obviously his testimonial, there was no decision to be made, I came straight out.
Now you're coaching as well now, so you must be excited about that, and you can give a bit of advice to John Hutchison stepping into that role.
I don't need to give him any advice. He'll be fantastic at it. He's a great man first and foremost. He's got a fantastic football brain, so I'm sure he'll be great at the job.
Great to see you, Chris Doig.
Thanks very much. Cheers.
Chris Doig down there with Luke Byrne, just seeing John Hutchison doing some media on the field. at the moment.
Just doing some comments for the print media there, and they're all huddled around as Luke's weaving in and out, looking for another interview there. But the crowds are hardly leaving. I think the players will walk around, sign autographs, and shake hands after the game.
I've got Eddie Bosnar down here. Eddie, a great night to celebrate one of the Mariners legends.
Yeah, it was a fantastic night. It's good to see so many people come out. The guy deserves it, so it's really nice that we were outside here tonight and we had a really enjoyable time.
John Hutchinson in the dressing room. What is it about John Hutchinson that everyone loves?
It's just that he's calm, he's collective, he's honest, and he works hard for the club first and foremost, and I think that's the most important thing.
Next season, big season for the Central Coast Mariners to regain that form that got them to the top of the table over the last few years.
Yeah, everything you just said then, that's what we need. But it's going to take a lot of hard work, and preseason is going to be really important, and I hope that if we do work hard, and which I know we will in preseason, that we'll be okay for next year and we'll do well.
Go well next season, Eddie Bosnar.
Thanks, mate. All the best.
So there was Eddie Bosnar down there with Luke Byrne. What a place to celebrate it too, the testimonial here at Plume Park. It could have been at Central Coast Stadium. It could have been at Tugger at the new training facility. But here it was at Plume Park and in front of such an intimate crowd. And I think that's what John Hutchinson really wanted.
Yeah, absolutely. The intimacy, as you talked about, probably wouldn't have had the same effect at Central Coast Stadium, although that is the home of the Mariners. This is the home of local football here. And look, the recent redevelopment a couple of years ago has made this into a wonderful local facility and a fitting venue with this crowd for this game.
Gentlemen, I've got Patrick Swansvike, Joshua Rose down here, pitch side. Big night for John Hutchinson and a good way to see him finish off his career.
Yeah, and I think a good win for the Blues. Hutch, not with a penalty. No, great night. And what a turnout. Like, it's good to see your local heroes getting rewarded for the 10 years and the years before that. So yeah, great that all these people turned up and great spectacle from the boys either side.
It was good to see the old fellas turn on, Rosie.
Yeah, a bit too quick for us tonight. Nah, it was a good night. It's good to see all the old faces again. Just enjoy yourselves.
Out of all the boys in the blue, who do you think will go around still playing professional football?
Oh, probably a majority of them could, I reckon. Still got, you never lose class, I think. They all have still got a good touch and still plenty of energy. So, there's definitely six or seven of them that could still do it, I think.
Patrick, you think you could go around one more season?
Oh, not me, because this is an extra large shirt and I feel very tight in this one. So, but I say if there were more clubs in Australia, I think a lot of these players would still play when they didn't have to make a choice that early or due to injury, of course, you never know. But if there were more clubs, I think definitely there were a lot of those players would still play, like Heffernan, Beecham and Pondiac and Burnie, of course, will play, but Simmel will still be in Australia, so Yoshi might play another year. So, yeah, and I think that the list goes on and on. Maybe not Tony and myself and Sash. Mergers may be a good comeback for some up front. but it's in the end, it's great. It's been a great night, and the weather was fortunate tonight, so it's been great. It's been supported by the local media and TV, and that's great effort to everyone.
Disappointed in your performance that you didn't get on the score sheet?
No, I scored my last goal was in the grand final. I think can't go better than that. So all the guys that scored today, great for them and perfect for them to round it up tonight.
Rosie, a new Golden Boot winner here at the club. Liam Reddy, he must be over the moon about winning with three goals.
Yeah, I think Tony can save some wages in the salary cap now. We'll just put Rocket up front. We'll Rocket up front next year and problem solved, I think.
Well done, boys. Enjoy the night.
And there we have it. The Central Coast Mariners versus the Hutch 11. It was the Hutch 11 that was victorious. 12-5 here at Plume Park. Luke Byrne, thank you very much for joining us down there on the touchline in pretty cool conditions here in Lizarro.
Yeah, I got warm, boys. There was a few goals scored this evening. Great night for football, and congratulations, John Hutchinson, on 10 years of football here at the Central Coast Mariners and a stellar professional career.
There we are, Luke Byrne down there with Michael Komet. John Hutchison for the final time leaves the field as a player. Be back next season, though, as a coach.
He will be back. He will be back bigger and better. John Hutchison as a coach, as he said. And what an honour to be here tonight to witness it. And to see John Hutchison go around for the final time and to see all the legends come back and play in this game. Very entertaining game and fantastic to see so many people come out tonight to celebrate what has been a wonderful career.
Well, on behalf of Central Coast League Club, VPA Productions and Coast FM, the Central Coast Mariners 11 defeated by the Hutch 11, 12-5. It's a good night from Plume Park.
Central Coast Leagues is proud to announce a significant internal redevelopment of the club, which will commence in the next couple of months and will take close to 12 months to complete. Included in the development is new reception areas, our fresco gaming and updated dining facilities throughout the ground floor of the club. These changes will be a great refresh of the facilities and enable members to sit in comfort and enjoy a drink or dine with friends. The plans of the new facilities will be on display in the club in the near future.